This is the longest using impossible on a real YouTube play button. 50 uppercase abbreviated characters from an original 382 character long YouTube username. The username on this play button is so long that they literally had to make the font slightly smaller, especially for this play button. But since I've already got the longest username on a YouTube play button, today I thought, let's try and get the shortest. So over the last couple of years, I've received a lot of YouTube play buttons. Too many, some might say. So a while ago, YouTube politely asked me to stop. So rather than creating another YouTube channel and getting another 100,000 people to subscribe, at first I wanted to try the easy method, which is just buying someone else's play button. So over a year ago, I got this email from a YouTube channel simply named F. They basically told me they had over 240,000 subscribers and they were wondering if I was interested in their super short username play button. So I was thinking, fantastic stuff. I don't have to do any of the effort of trying to get 100,000 subscribers. I just have to spend $200 or whatever on someone else's play button. So I emailed back asking, do they already have a silver play button for this channel? And they told me they did already have a silver play button for this channel. So then I simply asked for them to send me a picture of said play button and they never emailed me again. And when you now search on YouTube for channels that are called F, there is not a single channel with over 100,000 subscribers. But alas, do not fear, because 5 months later, I got a similar proposition. Someone with a channel called X had over 170,000 subscribers, and they told me they already had three silver play buttons. One was called Chris from X, one was called Nate from X, and the other was simply the letter X. They even went as far as linking the channel in the first email. I clicked on it, everything looked good. But then, I started getting greedy. I thought to myself, is the letter X really the shortest possible username that we could possibly get on a real silver play button? Because here's the letter X, but look at this, it's the letter I, and the I is thinner than the letter X. You know what's even smaller than a letter I? A full stop. So I thought, let's make sure we're getting the shortest username possible. Let's ask them to ask Society Awards if they can have a play button with a full stop on it. A couple of weeks went by and then they got an email from Jake from Society Awards. Jake seems to be the head honcho these days. It looks like Michael's out of the picture and now it's all about big lad Jake. But Jake queried the request because a full stop does not match the actual channel's username. Eventually he declined the full stop idea, so they went back to just having X printed on a play button. At which point Jake said, you can't even have this anymore. You can only have Nate from X. Nate from X? That's 11 whole characters. How dare you, Jake? So with one last attempt, I drafted an email for them to send to Jake, hoping that maybe they would allow us to have the one character X username. But as you can see, the people that I was communicating with via Discord have since deleted their Discord account. So confused by this, I went back to the original email that I got from these guys, and I clicked on their YouTube channel that they sent me, and the YouTube channel no longer existed. It had been deleted. There is some kind of conspiracy going on. YouTube do not want me to get this play button. That's right, it was time to accept that if I want the shortest username on a play button, I'm going to have to take control and get a whole new YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers for the 11th time. But what YouTube channel could we possibly make? I've already got a whole channel dedicated to geography, a whole channel dedicated to my car. I have a channel dedicated to Pop-Up Pirate, for God's sake. And we've already got a clips channel, so what am I possibly going to do? That's right, another clips channel. That is where I came up with No Context, Jack Sucks at Life. The concept behind this channel was simple. Every single day, there would be a random clip from one of my old videos that has absolutely no context and sounds really weird. For example, this video here. 4 seconds long, give it a watch. That's lovely. Great stuff, Jack. 100,000 subscribers coming soon. And so 4 months ago, I launched the channel in a Jack Sucks at Stuff Reddit video. I've got some exciting news. I'm making a new channel again. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing No Context Jack Sucks at Life. The channel gained 28,000 subscribers in just one day. And then it kind of immediately dropped off and was gaining subscribers very, very slowly. Yeah, like it literally took absolutely ages. But we continued to release daily content onto that channel. I even hired people on Fiverr to promote the channel for me. And eventually, after 3 long months, 100,000 subscribers was reached. Now I know what you're thinking. Jack, No Context Jack Sucks at Life is not a very short username. It's 26 whole characters long. That's more characters than Jack Sucks at Geography. What the hell are you talking about? Well, it's quite simple. My genius plan is, once the channel surpassed 100,000 subscribers, I would change the username to the shortest thing I could think of, and then apply for the play button. And hopefully, because the username matches what I import on the play button, Society Awards won't be able to argue. However, based on that email that Jake sent to the X channel, potentially he'll still have a problem with it. We will just have to see. So But about a month after hitting 100,000 subscribers, that little thing popped up saying I could redeem my play button. So I just needed to change the username and apply. But before we find out what happened, thank you so much, Honey, for sponsoring this video. Recently, I've been trying to get a bit more into my fitness. Obviously, you guys have noticed that already. But I need some new gear. So I found these nice retro shoes. Let's do size 9, add to bag. I need some new socks for my new shoes. There we go. Also, my YouTube bag's got a hole in it. So may as well get a new bag as well. Add to bag. Get it? Because it's a bag. Bloody no, £196. That's awfully expensive. But hold on a second. Who's this chirpy little fella? Apply coupons? Okay, then, I suppose. Oh my god, it's testing 3 coupons that it's automatically found by scouring the internet. Look at that. I've just saved £35.45. And I didn't even have to do anything other than click one button. And that is because I have got Honey. As you've just seen, Honey automatically searches the internet for coupon codes, so you don't have to. They work on all kinds of websites like clothing, video games, food. And the best part is, it's completely free. Those of you who've already downloaded Honey with my link and used it have found over $325,000 worth of savings. That is mental. There literally is no reason not to have Honey, so if you want to get Honey for yourselves, head to joinhoney.com/jack. Thanks, Honey, so much for sponsoring this video. Now let's get the shortest username on a play button. Okay, we are logged in to No Context JackSucksAtLife. We have 108,000 subscribers. I've just seen the channel's only earned £29 in the last 30 days. But that does not matter. We're not here for the money. We are here to get the world's shortest play button. So YouTube have already automatically sent me my redemption code, so I think all I need to do is click get my award. However, I am thinking maybe I need to change the name of the channel before I apply rather than after. If I'm definitely changing the name, surely it's smarter to change the name before, just in case it like doesn't update on their system or something. So this feels really odd, but I guess let's change the name of the channel. How do I do it? Not often I change a channel name. Normally I just kind of stick with it. Is it in customization? Branding? It could be in branding. No, it's basic info. Right, do I go for it? Verification badge. If you proceed with changing your name, you will lose your verification badge. Have I got a verification badge? Oh, I do. Look at me little tick. Well, that's sad. See you later. That's fine, though. It's worth it if this works anyway. Let's proceed. Oh, we're in. Right, so full stop is what I want to go with. You can see when it's empty, I can't click publish. But as soon as that full stop pops up, I can click publish. So I think that means that they will accept full stop as an official channel name. So do we go for it? I think we go for it. Okay, I'm quite scared. Publish! Sorry, the name cannot be used for your YouTube channel. Please try again with a different name. No! Curse you, YouTube! Right, well, what's the shortest name that they will allow? Could we just have a lowercase I? Or maybe an X? What's the coolest? I mean, lengthways, an I is a shorter character. Yes, according to this random guy on Reddit, a lowercase I is ever so slightly narrower than a lowercase L. Right, do I go for I? The lowercase I? I guess I do. Let's publish it. See if that works. Please. Changes published. Go to channel. Wait for it. Yes! That looks so stupid. How do I get my tick back? I want my tick back. Forget it, Jack. It's not important. You can sort it out later. My channel is called I. The 108,000 subscribers to this channel are going to be so confused when Big Daddy 2 is published in a couple of hours' time. Okay, now it is time to click get my award. Here we go. Oh, looks good. Get ready to celebrate. We've got some nice awards over on the right. And then it says congratulations on reaching a YouTube Creator Award milestone. We want to celebrate you and recognize the hard work you've put in to create great content and grow your channel and community. Oh, I'll tell you what, I've been working nonstop on this channel. It took up so much of my time sending a message to a fellow called Galvin asking if he wouldn't mind uploading daily clips to a channel while I sat on my ass doing nothing at all. Okay, we'll enter in our code and hopefully this works. Redeem award. Come on. Nothing's happening. Redeem award. Oh, we're in. Oh, here we are, YouTube channel name. Maximum number of characters, 50. Don't think that'll be a problem this time. It was a big problem last time we were here, but today, all I want is the letter I. Oh, look at that. It's going to look amazing presented to I for passing 100,000 subscribers. And grammatically, it kind of actually makes sense. Right, so they definitely could deny this, but I don't know on what grounds because it matches the name of the channel, so this should all work out. Let's approve and go to the checkout. Oh, good. It has been accepted by the computer, so it'll still be reviewed by a human, but this is looking good so far. So now I just need to enter all of my shipping details. We can say it's not going to cost us anything because it's a complimentary award if we view details. YouTube channel name, I. Right, I've entered all my details, so now I just need to click place order. They can't argue with this, surely. It all checks out. It matches the channel name, so you got to approve this, right? There's no way they can't approve this. We'll find out. I'm placing my order. There we go. Thank you for your order. We'll email you an order confirmation with your order details. Lovely. Can't wait to hear from you. Well, here we are. 2 months later. Why is this video taking so long? When I ordered my play button, I got the usual get ready for your silver award email, which I was very excited about. And then normally after about 2 weeks, you get an update email that looks something like this. This is the email that I got for my super long username play button, which basically gives you tracking information. And then a couple of days later, you get another email from a courier, which basically gives you your scheduled delivery slot time. However, I got absolutely nothing. I didn't get a single update other than that initial email. So after a couple of weeks, I reached out to Society Awards just asking for an update. And then out of nowhere, someone called Mary said, my award has been shipped and here's the tracker number. And I clicked on the tracker number and it was due in 2 days. What? And guess what? Here it is! Side note, when I got No Context JackSucksAtLife to 100,000 subscribers, I actually indirectly beat my Guinness World Record again. And they updated their website, and the description looks absolutely hilarious. Jack's channels are, Jack's have a YouTube channel full of fun times and fun hierarchies, Jack's a proper pirate, Sam Saws Apricots, JackSucks Geography, Turdboy420, JackSucksAtLife, JackSucks Stuff, Jack Messy Wells, JackSucks Clips. Jack's up a YouTube channel full of fun times and fun hierarchies, has nothing on me, I have the superior channel, I have more characters than all of Jack's YouTube channels combined, ha 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 ha, I have more characters than JackSucksAtLife, JackSucks Stuff, Jack Massey Wells, JackSucks Geography, JackSucks Clips, Samsung's Apricots, JackSucks Power Pirate, etc, etc. Imagine this on a play button, Jesus Christ, by the way, please subscribe, thank you very much, Hyrek XXXXXXX, and his newest one, named I. So hopefully, in my hands, is the shortest username on a play button. However, because we didn't get any of the usual updates, I'm kind of worried that something different happened and they went in and they just like changed it back to No Context JackSucksAtLife and didn't tell me or something. Also, in the last play button that I unboxed, they forgot to add the YouTube letter and the package by Rick card, so I'm very curious if it's in this one. If we take a look at the actual award itself, you can see that it has been approved by The Rick, which is very exciting. It's also been signed by a fella called Bill Sender. I'm only kidding, guys. I know there's no one called Bill Sender. Right, let's get this award open. This took way too long. Oh, I forgot to zoom the camera out. Sorry about that. Right, here we go. Shortest username on a play button. I'm ready. We've got the felt. We've got the felt. Yes, yes. We got the package by Rickard. Beautiful. Oh, it's been so long, Rick. I can finally complete my package by Rickshine. Yay. Oh, they've changed the font slightly as well. That's nice. I can also see that they've sent us the YouTube letter. It's just the standard updated letter. There's nothing unusual about it. So it's all looking promising. I reckon we've got the shortest username. Are we ready? Oh. I'm too scared to look. All right, here we go. Wait, wait, wait. Where's the text? Presented to. Oh, the font looks so small. Aye! We did it! We got the shortest username on a play button! Yeah! Oh my god. Look at that! And there's the recognize your team thing, but I don't care about all that. Where's my tape measure? Where's my tape measure? Oh my god. It's literally like 1 millimeter wide. Here we have the longest and shortest usernames possible on a real YouTube silver play button. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you're not already. Check out Honey, link in the description. Oh my god, we did it.